Welcome to Professor Mad, Physics for Everyone. Today we are going to study about the electric motor. An electric motor is a device that converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. A motor mainly consists of two parts, a stator and a rotor. The stator contains all the stationary parts of a motor, while the rotor contains the rotating parts. Stator comes from the word stationary. The stator contains parts such as brushes, magnets, and housing for the whole motor. Rotor comes from the rotate meaning. It dynamically moves when the voltage is applied to the motor. This will produce mechanical movement for a DC motor. Rotor is built from a shaft, armature core, commutator and armature windings. The very basic construction of a DC motor contains a current-carrying armature, connected to the supply end through commutator segments and brushes. The armature rotates with the commutators, while the brushes stand still touching the commutators. We know, we can make an electromagnet by wrapping a copper wire around a metal piece such as an iron nail. In a motor, the armature windings are wrapped around the metal armature core, so when we supply the power, the armature becomes an electromagnet. The polarity of an electromagnet can be changed by changing the direction of electric current through it. Likewise, magnetic polarity of the armature can be changed by swapping the current direction. Now say that we take this electromagnet and place it in the middle of two magnet poles as shown in the screen. The north end of the electromagnet would be repelled from the north end of the outer magnet and attracted to the south end of the outer magnet. The south end of the electromagnet would be repelled in a similar way. The armature would rotate like this. The key to an electric motor is to go one step further. The commutator and brushes work together to let current flow to the electromagnet, and also to change the direction of the current at just the right moment. The change of current causes the electromagnet to flip the poles and complete another half turn of motion. If the electromagnet poles were flipped at precisely the right moment at the end of each half turn of motion, the electric motor would spin freely. Thank you for watching us. Like and subscribe for more educational videos.